What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Corey B, man, and I'm back with a serious topic this time. You know, I know last video I said it was relationships, but nah. I was talking with a coworker at work, and with the mass shootings, the race heat, I guess you can call it, and tensions in America, there's something seriously wrong, and I feel like nobody really wants to talk about it because everybody feels like they're right, and that's the deep root of this issue. You know, everybody wants to point the finger. Those Trump guys said this. Well, those Democrats said this. The liberals said this. The libtards said this. The Republicans said this. But at the end of the day, anybody can say whatever they want to. It's up to you to actually decipher and listen to what somebody's saying, whether you agree or not. Now, I'm not saying, like, if somebody's a murderer or a KKK or, you know, somebody who just hates white people, I'm not saying that. Use common sense and discretion. And I feel like just people listening, man, love is what we miss. And I know it sounds basic and overly used, you know, it's generic. No, there is really no more love in this world, man. And that's something I am. I love smiling. I love talking to people. People hate my state. People hate Ohio. I love Ohio, man. I still want to move. But I love Ohio, man. Like, it's dope. And, you know, people take things for granted. And that's where I'm like, if you really knew what you had, you wouldn't even be complaining. Like, let's look at those people in Chicago, Detroit. These states that are American look like third world countries. They act like it. Like, it's a war zone out there. Now, I'm pretty sure even under this video, somebody's gonna comment, they're all Democrat ran and they're all this and that. Quit pointing the finger for a second. Go talk to these people. See what's going on. Find the deep-rooted issue and let's handle this. I'm getting tired of this same old same narrative. Like, it's really getting tired. And obviously nothing's done because, like, racial tensions in America are at an all-time high. And for you people to sit there and try to doubt that, you crazy. I hate to even say it, but as a black man, if you think I've never experienced racism in Ohio, but I'm not one to sit there and cry about it. It is what it is. I'm a grown man, you know. I don't sit back and cry about things I try to fix. So that's what this video is. Like, I wish people would share it, comment, and do all that, like, because we really need solutions. And you don't know how to help somebody until you ask. You know, trying to force ideas and positions on them, that's not how you do anything. You can't force somebody to like something. You can't force somebody to love Donald Trump. You can't force somebody to love Barack Obama. Especially if that person doesn't love themselves. And, you know, I said it as a joke at work with me and my boy Trevin. Shout out to him, Mr. Sneaker Kings, Ohio, man. I'll put the little link up here. America is right now is literally like a box of ice cream. You know that Neapolitan? You got the strawberry, the vanilla, the chocolate. And we all in this thing together. USA is just a big box, man. But right now, that box is deteriorating. It's getting wet and soggy. The ice cream's slipping out, man. And that's all the heat that is inside this box right now. And what I'm trying to do is put this bad boy back inside the freezer. because there's no reason that you have all this culture in here, all this flavor, and it's not good. What? People don't want to try this ice cream no more? I don't believe that. So, I believe if we talk more, and I want people not only to just share this video, I want y'all to make a video like just like this one, you know, and give me your input. If we all talk about this, get our real feelings and real emotions out, man, the area we could clear. So, you know, if you feel like for some reason the Democrats are the reason the world, like if you feel like the Republicans are this way, talk about it. Let's talk about it. But also be open-minded. Do not shut that person that's talking to you out. Listen with an open mind and an open heart. Because that's the only way we're going to get over this situation right now. You know. And, you know, one of the issues I even seen people used to talk about was like with Colin Kaepernick. He hates America and all that. Are you saying that because that's a narrative you made up? Do y'all really even think Trump is racist? Or is it just because of the supporters? Is it just, do you really know if he said anything super, like, really hateful? That's all I'm saying, man. Open your minds up a little bit, you know? And if you really believe those things, talk. Explain. Let's get this out in the air. Because I'm ready to fix this now. Not tomorrow. Not in a little bit. Now, listen, there is no reason people who support Black Lives Matter and Trump supporters can't be cool. I just don't believe that. Why do people who have opposing views have to all of a sudden become enemies? Like, when did this narrative happen? When did people become so sensitive to an idea different than theirs that you automatically have to hate the next person's idea? You know, that to me is another deep-rooted issue. I just don't understand. And I'm not talking politics and none of that. I'm not good with that. I do not speak on stuff that I don't know about. So I'm not going to say what president did good, which side is better when it comes to economics and money and all that stuff. I really don't know. I'm a regular working man. I focus on me and my future. And it just seems like politicking is running the world right now. People are scared to be individuals. But I tell you what, it's not going to always be like this, and it will end. When, I don't know, but things are going to change. And I got absolute faith in people. I know a lot of y'all gonna look at me and be like, what? Yeah, I believe in people, man. I believe people want to do better. It's in our nature. But we don't know how, because we get scared. You know, that's why a lot of people look up to these big politicians, big wigs. They don't look in themselves. They need a higher being, you can call it, to look at. When you are that higher being, people just don't know, man, the strength you got. You could change the world. You could do whatever you want to. But not until we stop all this closed-minded. That's crazy part. It's, people are closed-minded and sensitive at the same time. How? I don't know, man. I don't know. It's just me rambling, though, man. Like, I had to get this off my chest. It's just been stewing and brewing, man. It's been on the stove for a minute. This pot is bubbling. There's there's some ducks in the road. I'm down here at Monument Park in Canton. If you're familiar, you know these little ducks be crossing the street, man. But anyway, I'm just rambling, man. This pot's been on the stove bubbling, and I had to just take the top off real quick, you know, let the steam out before I bubbled over and became one of these crazy hateful people, man. But whether you believe in a God or a higher being or not, that don't mean nothing. I believe in my faith, and what you believe is what you believe. You don't have to worry about it. Keep it to yourself. But me personally, I believe in my faith, things will get better. I can promise you that. But there's always a storm. Always a storm. You know, and it's just a matter of how strong you are and if you're ready for that weather. Because when that snow come down and you freezing and that heat come, you sweating and can't even breathe, or that wind blowing, you ain't got no daggone windbreak on. You ain't got no jacket. You ain't got nothing. You just facing every single element. That's where your strength comes from, when you got to look at yourself. But I'm a quit preacher, man. Like, I ain't no Negro Domus or nothing like that. I'm just, like I said, a regular working, as you see it, regular working black American man. You know, and I ain't scared to say that. I don't believe in the whole, oh, let's not use, oh, black. Don't say that. Don't say white. Like, oh, you soft. I'm a black man. I love my culture. I love my history. And I love my future. And if you white, you can love that. Don't let nobody tell you, oh, your ancestors, whatever. Who cares what your ancestors did? Be you. You still show love to your same group of people, your same, you know, whatever you got going on, you good, man. But anyway, man, we're getting to the end of this video. Sorry that's so random and so discombobulated, but like I said, this topic is really, it's just mind-blowing, and it's hard to stay on one topic because it reaches so many different areas and facets of life that need fixed right now. So you know, let's quit with the bashing. Let's start teaching, man. That's the issue. We can uplift without bringing other people down, because bringing down somebody, you know, to you is something simple. But if you really thinking about it, when you bring down a man who stands on his own, you're bringing down his family, whoever supports him, and all that. You know, like, and when you're just pointing the finger, just doing that, oh, you're wrong, you're right, with no narrative. Of course, his backing and his family and his support is going to come negative at you. You know, so let's try to lift. That's what I want our you know, new thing to be. Let's try uplifting people, man. Aren't y'all tired of the same negative responses and all that? Like, we obviously ain't getting nowhere. All we doing is more hate, more hate, more hate. We are literally pouring gas, nitroglycerin, alcohol, all on this fire we call hate in America. I mean, we are. It's huge, you know? But give me your ideas. You talk about it. You know, I'm just one regular working man. You know, I don't do nothing special besides talk and listen. I actually listen. I'm not listening to respond. I listen to understand. And that's what we all can do. That it's not hard. You just gotta shut up. Yeah, it's that simple. Shut your mouth. So, all right, y'all. I'm off of here for now. I'm a little hungry, man. I'm doing this intermittent fasting thing, and it's my window's closing, man. So I gotta get some food in before. I think it's 6 o'clock. Yeah. But we're gonna continue back on with the regular weight loss videos and the relationship video coming too. We're gonna talk about love more. We ain't just gonna talk about loving people. Now we're gonna talk about loving a significant other. I ain't do that Mickey Mouse thing, you know. Yeah. We gonna talk about significant others, man, because if y'all was loving them right, like you can love yourself right, you gonna be some happy people. But anyway, it's Corey B, man, and I'm out. Peace.